heard about Sean, right?
No, what happened to Sean?
Well, you know he was selling acid, right?
No, man, I told you, $25, man. $25, it's inflation.
I just want to start this off by saying that this is Matthew Lillard's best performance, and it's not even close. Fuck you, Scream. This film does an amazing job at making the viewer laugh and also relate to all the chaos happening on screen. Matthew's character Steve-O is this originally Mormon Catholic geek who then turns to the 1980s punk lifestyle in order to find out what he wants to do with his life. He also does so in the name of not conforming to society because he hates conformity but doesn't realize that he begins to conform to the punk lifestyle, which I thought was pretty silly. Also, the diction and phrases used in this film are so fucking funny and out of nowhere and never overdone. Bob's personality is so loud and annoying that I can't help but to relate him to real life people. It makes me laugh and think about stupid shit my friends do or say whenever he's talking on screen. Their words take us through their story, and not only their words, but the camera work and editing makes us feel like we are in that little group with them, and it's perfect. Not only that, but you leave your viewing remembering stupid shit you used to do and how your decisions have shaped you into who you are. This film was perfectly relatable, comfortable, and awesome.
Mr. Baxter, concertor. You look like a Baxter.
Get out of the way, Mickey. See if the fellas would like a drink.
Oh, the murder one.
Let me start off by saying that literally fucking everything about Snatch is hilarious. From the accents, the characters' personalities, the action sequences, and the entire tone of the film. Brad Pitt being this mystical Irish one-punch man is so outlandishly stupid that it gets a couple knee slappers from me. Not only Brad Pitt, but the whole cast does an amazing job at keeping you not only entertained, but laughing the entire time as we follow our characters through their witty grunge perspectives, through their convoluted story. All these personalities mesh so well together in a hot-headed, obviously unserious way that we can't help but keep watching as our story goes on. One thing I believe about Snatch is that it will be an all-time cult classic. I don't hear many people talk about Snatch, but every time I do, it's always positive. Snatch is also not only extremely funny, but also extremely well-written. So if you're not a big fan of comedy, but you like a good story, then this comedy is for you.
So I think if we short Pfizer,
$430,000 in 1 month, Jordy? Huh? $430,000 in one fucking month!
Now, hold on. Let me start off by saying that I find this film funny in the way I believe Martin Scorsese was trying to depict, and that is in the way of laughing at Jordan Belfort and all his stupid co-workers and actions. The film does an exceptional job at showing the extremely rich, dangerous, and shitty-valued life of Jordan Belfort in the most hysterically amusing way. Not only that, but the writing is also undoubtedly hilarious, like this film was really made to make you laugh in just every scene possible. The acting also complements the writing in this way, as it is so extremely over the top and overdone that you can't help but keep watching. I would recommend this film to anyone who's trying to laugh at some stupid yuppie man as they miserably fail. There's also a conversation in this movie glorifying Jordan Belfort's life, but to be honest, whenever I saw the film, I didn't envy his life at all. I just finished it thinking, wow, what a terrible person, but that was so fucking funny, and that was it. Lastly, something I believe genuinely boosts the humor of this movie is the fucking New York accent that every character has. Movies that have that damn Boston or New York or Bronx accent are always 10 times funnier, especially The Fighter. I'm looking at you, The Fighter. Anyway, yeah, The Wolf of Wall Street. If you haven't seen it, it's a good laugh. I would recommend it. Go see it. I remember I first saw Shaun of the Dead when I was like 7 or 8. My family actually had it on DVD, I think, and we would watch it on our Xbox 360. Now, from ages 9 to 17, I couldn't really remember the scenes of the movie, so then I rewatched it, and it still held up very well, especially with my humor nowadays. It's a film that's extremely self-aware, and in fact, is actually making fun of the zombie horror genre as we know it. They use corny tropes and practices that other zombie movies do, all the while keeping us hooked to the film through the relatability we feel to the characters. I mean, Sean is literally not even living and basically a zombie himself, as his life is so boring. He also just sees the world around him in a pretty gray, dull perspective, and it isn't until the zombie apocalypse actually starts that he really starts to give a fuck. One thing that every amazing comedy needs to have is extremely well-written dialogue. One thing Shaun of the Dead does differently is its actual use of all of its resources. Something comedy films do a lot that faults them is that they only focus on the writing and lines and forget all about the camera work, the choreography, the character personalities, the hidden metaphors, and everything else that film uses to enhance our viewing experience. It's these techniques that make Shaun of the Dead its very own. It has forever referenceable lines between our characters as they take an especially minor approach to a literal zombie apocalypse. Shaun of the Dead is perfect for those who love self-aware, ironic, smart humor. Definitely recommend it. Definitely go see it. Yeah, Shaun of the Dead.
You got a purty mouth.
Zombieland is so fucking silly. I first saw Zombieland again when I was like around 9 or so, and it was instantly a classic for me. The acting from the entire cast is perfect to add to this awkwardly witty zombie movie, but it's especially our main character who's played by Jesse Eisenberg and another character played by Woody Harrelson who catch my attention when I see this film. Woody Harrelson is this Texan quote-unquote badass. He's just super cool for no reason, and to me, it's peak comedy. His lines are very southern and really catch you off guard. His character even ends up creating some of the most iconic lines from the film. Jesse Eisenberg's character is this awkward, socially inept dude who plays fucking what at Warcraft and who we follow throughout our story. He takes an unrealistically organized approach to the literal zombie apocalypse as he ends up having 33 rules that he lives by and remembers as he survives. His speech patterns are so awkward and just out of social timing, and it makes his character relatable to a lot of people, which is another thing that pulls people towards this film. The whole film itself is literally written and produced to make you laugh, and it works. This film takes unexpected twists and turns that usual zombie flicks don't, and it works in every which way. From the Twinkie scene, to Jesse's almost girlfriend turned zombie, to so much more. It's exceedingly unserious, it's culturally comfortable, it's Zombieland.
Dicks? Like a man dick?
Yeah. Man, dick.
I mean, come on, it's super bad, dude. Super bad, as most people know, is like the ultimate man movie. These teenagers are so unapologetically teenage boys, and it's so funny. I like to think that the writers were unaware of this and were just writing what they thought was funny, as Seth Rogen has said in interviews that he started writing the script in high school. Knowing this makes seeing the whole film 10 times funnier, from the obsession with dicks to the overtly sexual Jonah Hill to McLovin to the dumbass cops played by Bill Hader and Seth Rogen. Superbad is the perfect comedy for any man, boy or grown. Now that's not to say no one else can enjoy it, I just feel like the film is surrounded around stupid boy humor and that's what it executes perfectly. Superbad has a special kind of writing to it as it's the literal things that teenage boys would say. It captures the awkwardness and stupidness of teenage boys in a way that makes it relatable to any teenager. We all know a fucking McLovin or Seth. Not only is the film relatable, but it also has this kind of warmness to it as everything works out in such a comedic way for our main characters. The relatability of Superbad and over-the-top masculine humor meshes together in a way that instantly places itself as a cult classic.
What's that? You're outside?
This guy here?
You know what? He just left.
Yeah, Scott Pilgrim versus the World, yeah! I've always been a big fan of Scott Pilgrim vs. the World ever since I first saw it when I was like 10 or so when my brother would watch it, and it's always been a favorite. The film takes this geeky 8-bit shitty moral approach to this insanely outlandish plot of Scott having to beat Ramona's 7 deadly exes. We are complemented by graphics of little 8-bit words and onomatopoeias and exceedingly stimulating VFX as he does so, and the writing is just hilarious.
The lines from Scott are straight out of something a 20-whatever-year-old would say, and it's relatable for many.
I'm not relating to Scott's first girlfriend, Knives, but I am relating his awkward speech patterns and his unawareness to certain social cues to real-life people I know, and it's really fucking funny. The whole video game aesthetic to this film is also literally so, like, unique. I haven't seen another film do as well as Scott Pilgrim using the video game-esque look. It complements our story perfectly and it makes this film forever referenceable and, again, a cult classic.
It's just weird, because seems like someone definitely touched my drum set.
Yeah, that is weird, because I didn't touch him.
Hey! Did you touch my drum set?
Hey, knock it off!
It's fucking Step Brothers, dude. Step Brothers is the peak of comedy, I just want to start off by saying that, I don't care. Will Ferrell and John C. Reilly do an amazing job at depicting the little connections and humors of a growing relationship between these two men who are essentially the same. They both live at home, they're both lazy, they're both stupid. The jokes told in this film are so situationally effective and work very well between the dialogue across characters. Not only that, but the situations they find themselves in are hilarious. The iconic drum set scene is something I can never forget, and I don't know if that's because I first saw this film when I had a young developing brain and my memory grew with that scene, or if it was just that good. I think I could say that this was the starting point of my now curated humor. The excessive masculinity to every joke and line in this film is something that attracts me, as I can't help but turn my brain off and just laugh and be like, oh yeah, it's good, that's good, you know? These two dim-witted men go head-to-head the entire movie as they learn to live with each other and accept each other, and it all comes together so well. Step Brothers is peak male comedy, and I don't want to hear it. If you somehow haven't seen Step Brothers, please go see it now. Yeah, no question, this is the best comedy film of all time. Napoleon Dynamite offers a humor and relatability sort of like Zombieland's Columbus, and that is the pinnacle of the awkward, socially inept loner high schooler. Napoleon Dynamite grows up in what's probably the worst state to grow up in, and that's Idaho. Just a huge countryside that's majorly empty and soulless. The film is pretty much just Napoleon Dynamite's life in this barren land as he lives this totally normal high school life. It's just through the perspective of him. We feel just as awkward as each situation feels, and we feel exactly how the film wants us to feel. Depending on what kind of personality you have, you can either laugh relating with Napoleon or laugh at him. Either way, it offers a humor that appeals to many. You've probably seen people wearing the infamous Vote for Pedro shirt, as we are shown in one of the final scenes featuring Napoleon dancing to sway votes for Pedro's school presidency wearing the shirt. The lines spoken from Napoleon are also the most referenceable and most used lines I've used from any movie. I got like 3 feet of air that time.
You got like 3 feet of air that time.
Line is something I use almost daily, whether I'm imagining a conversation between two teens hopping across rocks at the park, or I myself am happening to leap over or across something. His freaking idiot and dude my freaking tots are just a few more examples of the comedic masterpiece. It's so simple, yet done so uniquely favorable that I feel like everyone can find a piece of themselves in Napoleon Dynamite. Napoleon also happens to find himself in many situations, and no matter if the situation is out of the ordinary or not, Napoleon's reaction to whatever it is just makes it so much funnier. The film's non-saturated, emotionless setting paired with Napoleon's unaware awkwardness just all comes together in the most hilariously relatable and offsetting way. Napoleon Dynamite is for the people, by the people.